Hey guys, so I'm in one of my older ships right now, which I've managed to upload to the workshop for a backup because I want to talk about whether or not you need maintenance tunnels in your ships. So there's three types of ships in terms of whether or not they have a maintenance tunnel. The first type is the kind of ship where you can access all the components from inside the ship, like this one. So this type of design is the most convenient in terms of maintenance, but it's also the most inefficient because you will have to make room for the walking area, and there's just a lot of stuff that you can cram and add to your ship if you don't make it this way. So this kind of ship design where you can access everything from the inside is best used for non-combat ships. I mean, you can use this kind of design for combat ships, but it will be a lot more inefficient than it has to be. All those PCU that you spend for making this room for maintenance access could have been used for more weapons or more fuel or more protection for combat ships. Alright, so that's the first type. Let's talk about the second type now. The second type is the kind of ship that doesn't have any maintenance tunnel at all. The advantage of this design is that it's very efficient because you're not making any unnecessary space on your ship, and you can spend all that PCU on your weapons, fuel, and protection. But the disadvantage of this kind of design, as you might have guessed, is that it's kind of inconvenient to repair. Now, the way to kind of go around this limitation is to have your ship designed in such a way that a welder, like a big ship welder like this, can still reach inside from the outside, because a welder can reach 3 or 2 blocks inside the ship. So even though this is very cramped, you can still fix everything inside the ship using a giant welder like this. But of course, if you don't have that kind of welder, then you will have to like grind and fix things by grinding into the ship. So you might think that's a very big disadvantage, the inconvenience, but when you think about how often a ship gets in combat on Space Engineers, it's really not that bad, because it's better to have a more efficient combat ship and then kind of go through the inconvenience of repairing it later than having a convenient ship that is not efficient in combat to begin with. Alright, so now let's talk about the third type of maintenance tunnel, and that is something that's like in between the two types that we saw earlier. So this is one of my older warships, and even though you cannot access all the internals, there are still maintenance tunnels where it's hard to reach. So for example, this is one of the maintenance tunnels, and as you can see, I can repair a lot of things from here. And there's also one that leads to the back of the ship over here. So this is still kind of wasting efficiency in my opinion, because all this space could have been used for something else that are more functional, but it's a good compromise between efficiency and convenience if you really don't like the idea of having to grind into your ship or having to use a big welder to repair your ship for any damage. Then this kind of maintenance tunnel design is a good compromise, where you can still have a relatively efficient ship design, but it's also convenient to repair or maintain in case it gets damaged. You can alleviate or compensate some of the defense or protection loss by using a passage block, for example, but that's still a loss in efficiency, in my opinion, compared to just having a tight ship without maintenance tunnels. So, those are the three types of maintenance tunnels and their pros and cons.